Shares in Sunrise Resources rose earlier this week after the group announced that it had expanded its Pozz project in Nevada by staking a second deposit. The CS project comprises 15 new claims staked by the group. Executive Chairman Patrick Cheetham's on the line. Patrick, good to catch up with you again.
Morning, Andrew.
Tell us a little bit more, first of all, about the second deposit and where it is.
Okay, well, the CS project, it's located in the southern part of Nevada, and it's the second project that we've acquired under our umbrella initiative, which we call the Pozz project, as you rightly say. So what we're doing, the Pozz project is an initiative to search for new sources of natural pozzolan. We believe there's a real opportunity in natural pozzolan, and it might be worth me just saying a little bit about what pozzolan is, because it's not something that sort of trips off everyone's tongue. So what pozzolan is, it's basically any material which, when you mix it with lime and water, has cementitious properties. And the reason that it's used is it's used as a replacement in concrete for Portland cement, because when you produce Portland cement, you're producing a ton of carbon dioxide for every ton of cement produced. So pozzolans provide a green alternative. And traditionally, it's been fly ash from coal-fired power stations that's gone into this market. But as coal-fired power stations are phased out and as the quality of fly ash deteriorates with increasing emission controls, so the opportunity for pozzolan is growing. So it's quite a pivotal time in the industry, I think.
Well, I'm glad that you answered that. Otherwise, there was a risk I was going to have to ask a fairly stupid question. So I'm glad you addressed that. But look, how big is the potential market for it? You mentioned there is a market, but it's a growing market.
It's a growing market. You know, if you look back a couple of years, then some of the deposits were only producing small amounts of pozzolan, but now they're sort of working sort of 7 days a week and 24 hours a day to meet demand. And there was a particular shortage of the alternative coal-fired fly ash last year. And we think that's a sort of a continuing trend. So, you know, the markets in the States are quite small at the moment, but growing. But elsewhere in the world, the use of natural pozzolan is much more developed. So, you know, a place like Saudi Arabia and in Europe. In fact, the original natural pozzolans came from the use of Roman cement almost 2,000 years ago.
So now's a good time, you reckon, to be developing it?
Yeah, we think so. I think it's a good time to be acquiring these deposits. We can acquire them at very low cost by staking. And so, you know, we're learning all the time as to what makes the best sort of pozzolan and sort of developing that as we acquire our new project. So, you know, the initial project, the Pozzash project, seems to fit the bill, but the new project has a higher glass content, which is one of the critical aspects of natural pozzolans.
Have you got your eye on any other deposits there?
Well, we're doing research at the moment. We may acquire additional projects. You know, transport costs for natural pozzolan are a major factor. So it's important that the deposits that we have are close to infrastructure, which they are. You know, we need to be aware of where the market is, which is the, you know, cement and concrete plants in California primarily.
So going forward, Patrick, what are the big steps for you? What's the main focus at the moment?
Okay, well, we know from our chemical analysis already that both projects meet the chemical requirements for natural pozzolan. But what we need to do, particularly on the new deposit, is to do some concrete testing. So basically, you mix it with Portland cement as a replacement material, and then you test its strength and its various other physical properties. You know, one of the major problems with using ordinary Portland cement, apart from the carbon dioxide emissions that go with its production, is the increasing incidence of concrete cancer. Often the natural pozzolans can address the issues that cause concrete cancer and make a much better, more enduring concrete.
Always good to speak to you, Patrick. Thanks for the update.
Okay, thank you.